Hi guys, this is Engineer Jack. So yung topic natin for this presentation is about the design of doubly reinforced concrete beams. So usually yung given dito, meron tayong MU or this is the factored maximum moment. So for example, meron tayong simply supported beam and meron tayong uniform loading. So yung uniform loading natin ay syempre yung gagamitin natin yung factored uniform load na that is equal to 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. So yung MU nga natin, that is also equal to M max or yung maximum moment of our beam. So kung meron tayong simply supported beam and uniform loading, yung MU natin is equal to WU L squared all over 8. So yung L dito is the length of the beam. And itong derived formula, this is for uniform load only. Another given dito guys sa design of doubly reinforced concrete beams, meron tayong dimensions B and H. So yung dimensions of the section. And the material strengths FC prime and FY. So yung FC prime, this is the concrete strength or the compressive concrete strength. And yung FY natin, this is the yield strength of our steel. So when the factored moment MU is greater than the design strength VMN of the beam, when it is reinforced with the maximum permissible amount of tension reinforcement, compression reinforcement becomes necessary. Ibig sabihin, if our MU is greater than VMN max, and yung VMN max natin is equal to VAS max FY times D minus A halves, or ibig sabihin, yung VMN natin, ginamit natin dito yung pinaka-maximum tension steel reinforcement natin for singly. Or yung ginagamit nga natin na symbol is AS max. So yung AS max, yan yung maximum tension steel reinforcement natin. Na yung AS max natin, that is also equal to rho max times BD. And yung rho max natin, yung ginagamit natin na formula is 0.003 plus epsilon y or yield strain all over 0.007 times rho balance. Pero guys, may mga authors guys na yung ginagamit nila is 0.85 FC prime beta 1 all over FY times 3 over 7. Actually, itong formula, galing yan din dito. Kasi pag sinimplify natin itong unang formula for phi max, yung rho balance natin, that is 0.85 FC prime beta 1 all over FY times 600 all over 600 plus FY. So, kung mapapansin nyo guys, itong 600 all over 600 plus FY, that is stresses. So, kung mag-divide tayo ng 200,000 or the modulus of elasticity sa numerator and denominator, that is also equal to 0.003 all over 0.003 plus yield strain or epsilon y. So, kung mapapansin nyo, magka-cancel itong 0.003 plus yield strain. So, yung maiiwan is 0.003 all over 0.007. So, pag simplify natin yan, babalik tayo dito sa formula derived na 0.85 FC prime beta 1 all over FY times 3 over 7. So, either of the two, pwede niyang gamitin. So, kung saan kayo guys mas komportable, okay lang naman. So for doubly guys, pag magde-design tayo, kung magde-design tayo ng doubly reinforced concrete beam, kailangan natin ng additional reinforcement. So yung kailangan natin is additional tension reinforcement, kaya meron tayong AS2, and meron tayong additional reinforcement naman sa taas, which is the compression steel or AS prime. Na yung MN nga natin, this is the bending moment from the original na single reinforced na analysis, na MN1 is equal to 0.85 FC prime AB, closing parenthesis times D minus A halves. Tapos yung additional moment naman na natin kailangan is yung tinatawag na MN2 and that is equal to AS prime, closing parenthesis FS prime or FY, closing parenthesis times D minus D prime. Kasi guys, nagamit ako ng OR kasi pwedeng hindi nag-yield ang bakal or nag-yield. Pag nag-yield, yung gagamitin natin is FY and pag hindi naman nag-yield, yung gagamitin natin is FS prime. So, yung kailangan natin sa design, itong dalawang moments na MN1 and MN2, and dapat greater than yung sum na yan sa MU natin or equal. So, dito guys sa MN1 natin na 0.85 FC prime AB, equal din naman yan sa AS1 FY kasi CC equals to T1 pa nag-summation of forces horizontal tayo. Kaya equal yan na formula for MN1. And for MN2 naman, pwede naman natin gamitin is AS2 naman or yung AS2 natin, ito yung additional tension steel reinforcement natin, times Fy times D minus D prime, kasi same yung moment arm nila, pag nag-moment tayo sa CS. So, pag in-equate natin guys yung CS tapos yung T2, yung ma-equate nga natin dyan is AS prime Fy is equal to AS2 Fy. Pero guys, hindi pa natin talaga sure kung nag-yield yung compression steel natin, kasi nga, naggumamit ako ng FS prime or Fy. Ngayon, sa for unang formula natin na MN1, yung MN1 natin, that is MN max din, na yung ginamit natin dyan is for AS max or yung maximum tension steel reinforcement natin. So, pag kulang nga yung MN natin, kahit gumamit tayo ng maximum AS, pag less than pa din siya sa MU, kailangan natin additional reinforcement nga na AS2 or for tension steel and compression steel. Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng MN2. Itong AS max na natin, ito yung gamitin natin na AS1 for our formula for MN1. And dito naman natin sa formula, kung sakali naman, if our compression steel does not yield or yung FS prime natin is less than Fy, ibig sabihin, yung compression steel reinforcement natin or AS prime is not equal to AS2. Pag pareho guys nag-yield yung compression steel natin and tension steel, yung additional reinforcement natin sa bottom and sa top equal. Pero kung hindi nag-yield yung compression steel natin, automatic yung AS prime natin is not equal to AS2. So yan yung tatanda naman natin kung magde-design tayo ng double reinforced concrete beam. So, para mas maintindihan natin guys yung pag-design ng doubly reinforced concrete beam, let's solve an example problem. So, the beam is loaded in a service dead load is equal to 25 kN per meter and the uniform service live load na 35 kN per meter. Compute the area of steel reinforcement for the section. So, walang sinabi kung saan, pero assume na natin guys yung i-solve natin is yung compression steel and tension steel. So, yung the beam has a simple span of 4.5 meters. Take Fc prime is equal to 20 megapascal, Fy equals to 400 megapascal, and assume D prime is equal to 60 millimeters, or ito yung tinatawag na steel cover, and one layer arrangement of tension steel. So, meron tayong dimensions of our section, meron tayong width na 250 millimeters, and effective depth na D equals to 410 millimeters. So, for solution, let's solve muna yung maximum factored uniform load natin. So, we will use 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. So, 1.2 times 25 kN per meter plus 1.6 times 35 kN per meter. That is 86 kN per meter. So, pwede nyo kasi pause yung video and i-check yung pagka-calculate ko. Tapos, yung gagamitin natin na maximum factored moment, mu is equal to wu l squared all over 8. So, substitute the values. So, meron tayong 86 times 4.5 meters square all over 8. Kasi yung length natin for our beam is 4.5 meters. So, yung mu now natin is 217.6875 kilonewton meter. So, ito yung factored maximum moment natin for our beam. So, ngayon, i-compare natin yan sa value natin for phi mn max. Na pag ginamit nga natin yung AS max, pag greater than yung MU dito sa value, ibig sabihin, i-design natin siya as doubly kasi nga, kulang yung reinforcement natin. Pero pag greater than itong value na phi mn max sa MU, i-design lang natin siya as singly reinforced concrete beam. So, yung AS max natin, that's also equal to rho max times BD nga, na yung rho max natin, pwedeng itong gagamitin natin na formula or pwedeng itong derived formula for phi max. So, let's use this second formula, guys. So, before natin, guys, magamit yan, wala tayong value for beta 1. So, check natin yung Fc prime. So, yung Fc prime natin, that's 20 megapascal. So, for NCP 2015, for Fc prime less than or equal to 28 megapascal, use beta 1 is equal to 0.85. So, since na less than yung 20 sa 28, syempre automatic yung gamitin natin na beta is 0.85. So, saka tayo mag-substitute ng values, guys. So, 0.85 times 20 for Fc prime, 0.85 beta 1 all over Fy na 400 times 3 over 7. So, meron tayong rho max na 0.01548214286. So, para makuha natin guys yung AS max, just multiply the rho max sa BD natin or the width times the effective depth. So, yung AS max natin, rho max times BD na yung B natin is 250 times effective depth na 410 millimeters. And that is 1,586.919643 square millimeters. So, ito guys yung maximum tension seal reinforcement natin. Or AS max. So, another solution guys, para makuha natin yung AS max, may mga authors na gumagamit ng C max equals to 3 over 7D. So, let's try gamitin yan para masolve natin yung AS max. So, meron tayong effective depth na D, that is 410. So, 3 over 7 times 410, that is 175.7142857 millimeters. So, equate naman natin guys yung T equals to C, pero take note, yung equate natin dito for singly muna. Kasi yung gagamitin niya natin is AS max. Kasi yung AS max, galing yan sa single reinforced concrete beam natin. So, yung T natin, that is AS max FY, sa kabila naman, meron tayong 0.85 FC prime A max over B. So, pag nagamit tayo guys ng AS max and A max, automatic, yung tension steel natin nag-yield yan. Kaya kahit hindi na natin guys i-check yung FS, automatic greater than yan sa FY. So yung AS max natin, wala tayong value, pero meron tayong value for C max. So pwede natin guys gamitin na yung A max, that is also equal to beta 1 times C max. Then pwede natin guys i-simplify yan. So yung AS max natin, that is also equal to 0.85 FC prime beta 1 C max times B all over FY. Then substitute the values. So 0.85 times 20 FC prime, 0.85 beta 1, 175.7142857 millimeters, that is C max. B equals to 250 millimeters all over 400 megapascal for FY. So, AS max is equal pa din na 1,586.919643 square millimeters. So, either of the two solutions class, pwede nyo guys gamitin para masolve yung AS max. So, itong formula guys, in solving the maximum AS or AS max, lahat yan guys galing sa epsilon S or net tensile strain na 0.004. So, ito yung limit natin in designing our beams. Kasi guys, yung 0.004, inilimit niya ng NCP or yung code natin hanggang sa transition region. At least yung strain natin, 0.004. So, pag kinuha natin guys yung actual stress of our tension steel, just multiply the value for net tensile strain na 0.004 sa 200,000 megapascal and that is 800 megapascal. So, 800 megapascal is greater than sa FY which is 400 megapascal. Ibig sabihin, nag-yield talaga yung tension steel reinforcement natin. So, yung mga formula natin pag naginamit para makuha natin yung AS max, na-derive nga yan sa 0.004 or 800 megapascal. Siyempre, yung gagamitin natin for value for phi din is galing din sa transition region. Kasi nga, yung net tensile strain natin is less than sa 0.005 na greater than din sa yield strain natin na 400 over 200,000 or 0.002. So, meron tayong derived formula na ginagamit sa NCP na for phi for transition region na 0.65 plus 0.25 closing parenthesis FS minus FY all over 1,000 minus FI. So, kailangan natin guys yung makuha yan para makompute natin yung phi, m, and max. So, meron tayong AS max, meron tayong FY, D minus A half, so meron tayong A na nakuha kanina gamit yung C max natin. So, just multiply the beta 1, kuha natin guys yung A max. So, yung gagamitin natin dito is A max and yung D naman is given na 410 millimeters. So, yung FS natin, merong value na 800. FY is 400. So, substitute the values. So, 0.65 plus 0.25, closing parenthesis, 800 minus 400 all over 1,000 minus 400. And that is 400 over 600. So, meron tayong value now for phi. That is 0.81666667. And saka natin guys, i-multiply yan para makuha natin yung phi, m, and max. So, yung gagamitin natin for A, galing yan sa beta 1C, na yung C natin is C max. So, beta 1 is 0.85 times C. So, yung A max natin is 149.357142 millimeters. So, ito yung gagamitin natin for this formula kasi nga, pag nagamit tayo ng AS max, automatic yung A natin is naka-maximum din. So, hindi ko na guys isa-isahin yan in substitute. So, just solve the value for phi m n. na yung maximum nga natin, that is 173.8285328 kilonewton meter. So, pwede nyo guys i-pause yung video and i-substitute yan sa formula and i-check kung pareho tayo guys ng sagot na 173.828 kilonewton meter. So, obviously guys, yung mu natin is greater than phi m and max. Ibig sabihin, we need additional reinforcements for this example problem. So ngayon guys, yung additional reinforcement natin na kailangan, syempre, dinesign natin siya. Kung kulang yung for singly natin na design, kahit gumamit tayo ng ASmax, so yung AS1 dito, gagamitin natin is ASmax na nga. So AS1 is equal to ASmax. So yung kailangan natin ng additional reinforcement, magdadagdag tayo sa tension steel reinforcement or at the bottom and at the top. So meron tayong AS2 and AS prime. Na yung AS prime natin, this is the additional compression steel reinforcement at the top of the beam. So after natin guys, masolve yung phi m and max, equal yan sa mu1 and phi m and 1. So yan yung design natin for singly nga. So yung mu natin, para mag-equal sa design natin, mag-additional tayo ng mu2. Kaya mu1 plus mu2. To simplify, for mu2 equal yan sa mu minus mu1. So, just substitute the values for MU and MU1. So, yung MU natin, that is 217.6875 kilonewton-meter minus MU1 na 173.8285328. So, yung MU2 natin that now is 43.8589672 kilonewton-meter. So, itong kailangan natin ng additional moment for our beam. So, wala tayo guys na MU2 pero meron tayong MN2 na value. So, yung MN2 natin na value for formula, meron tayong AS prime, FS prime or FY, kasi nga hindi natin alam kung nag-yield yung bakal natin sa taas, times D minus D prime. Or, AS2 times FY times D minus D prime. So, check natin pa din kung nag-yield nga. So, pag hindi nag-yield yung compression steel, automatic yung AS prime natin is not equal to AS2. Or, yung additional reinforcement nga natin sa tension, hindi equal sa additional reinforcement natin for compression. So, for MN2 guys, para makuha natin yan, equal yan sa MU2 all over phi. So, yung phi natin, yung ginamit natin kanina, for transition region. So, yung ginamit natin is 0.81666667. So, yung MN2 natin gamitin, let's say that is AS prime, times FS prime or FY times D minus D prime. So, para malaman natin guys, if our compression steel nag-yield, gagamitin natin na formula, FS prime is equal to 600 times C minus D prime all over C. And i-compare natin guys yan sa yield strength natin na 400 megapascal or FY. So, yung C natin nagagamitin natin sa formula dito is yung value natin na nakuha kanina na Cmax na 175.7142857 millimeters. So, substitute the value sa formula. So, 600 times C minus 60, yung 60 natin is the D prime or steel cover all over C na value. And that is also equal to 395.12195.12 megapascal. And that is less than FY. Ibig sabihin, yung compression steel natin does not yield. Ibig sabihin, pag hindi nag-yield yan, yung AS prime natin is not equal to AS2. So, ngayon, yung gagamitin natin na formula for MN2 na, instead na FY, yung gagamitin natin is FS prime. Kasi nga, hindi nag-yield. So, pwede natin guys ayusin yan. So, AS prime is equal to MN2 all over FS prime times D minus D prime. Kasi meron tayong value for MN2 na galing yan sa MU2 over phi. So, pwede din yan. And para makuha natin guys yung additional reinforcement sa taas or compression steel reinforcement or AS prime. So, itong gagamitin natin formula. So, just substitute the values. So, for MU, instead na naka-kilonewton meter tayo, gagawin natin naka-newton millimeters. Kasi yung values natin for D and D prime, naka-millimeters yan. Kaya, magbumultiply tayo ng 1 million for MU2. So, gagamitin natin is 43,858,967.2 newton millimeters all over beta na 0.81666667 times FS prime na 395.121952 megapascal times D minus D prime 410 minus 60. So, yung AS prime natin, that is 388.342.0052 square millimeters. So, pwede nyo guys i-pause yung video and i-check yung pagkakalculate ko. So, para man naman natin guys makuha yung AS2, kasi nga, pag hindi nag-yield, hindi din equal yung AS prime and AS2. Pero pag nag-yield yung compression still natin, automatic yung AS prime is equal to AS2. Or equal yung additional reinforcement natin for tension steel and compression steel. Pero for this problem, hindi nga nag-yield, ibig sabihin, i-resolve natin yung value for AS2. So, equate lang natin yung CS and T2. So, CS equals to T2, yung CS natin is AS prime FS prime kasi hindi nag-yield, equal to T2 na AS2 times FY. So, yung AS2 now natin is equal to AS prime FS prime times FY. So, using these values and formula na AS prime and AS2, substitute. So, meron tayong 388.342.0052 for AS prime times FS prime na 395.121.121.9512 megapascal all over 400 megapascal for FY. So, ibig sabihin yung additional reinforcement natin for tension steel is equal to 383.606.1271 square millimeters. So, yung AS prime natin, ito na yung compression steel natin na kailangan. And yung AS2 natin, ito yung additional reinforcement naman sa bottom or tension steel. Tapos, yung AS max naman natin na nakuha kanina, ito na mismo yung AS1 natin. And para makuha natin yung tension steel reinforcement natin, just add the AS1 and AS2. So, meron tayong value na 1,970.52577 square millimeters. So, ito na yung pinaka-total natin for tension steel. So, ito na guys yung sagot natin for the problem. So, yung additional natin for tension and compression, ito yung AS prime. And for tension steel, just add the AS max or AS1 plus AS2. So, kung gusto nyo guys makuha yung value for number of bars, syempre, kailangan natin yung formula for area of the bar. So, kailangan lang natin ng diameter of the bar na gagamitin natin para malaman natin kung ilan yung gagamitin natin ng number of bars sa compression steel and tension steel. So, that's it guys. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day.